Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss about the FIR filter design MCQ questions. So already I posted the three videos for that FIR filter design. So this is the fourth video. It's a realization of FIR filter. In this video, we are going to discuss about the questions about the realization or the representation, the diagrammatic representation of FIR filter. Okay. The first question, you see, in general, an FIR system is described by the difference equation y of n equal to summation k equal to 0 to n minus 1 bk x of n minus k. So the statement is true or false. It's a true. So the FIR system, so you know, FIR system means the system is having a finite number of impulse responses. So, and the discrete FIR system, it is described by the difference equation. So where the y of n is the output, x of n is the input, x of n minus k is the previous inputs, and bk is the filter coefficient. So summation k equal to 0 to n minus 1, bk x of n minus k, this is the difference equation in order to describe the FIR system. This is the true. Then the next one, how many multipliers are required to realize the FIR system in direct form? So in order to realize the FIR system in direct form, how many multipliers are required if that system is having the order n? Okay, if the system is having the order n, means we need n number of multipliers. Okay, so this is an important question. How many multipliers required in order to realize the FIR system in direct form means n. Similarly, how many adders are required to realize the FIR system in direct form means n minus 1 adders. Okay, if n is the that system equation, means we needed n minus 1 adder. Since n number of term is available in a y of n equation, so n number of term, in order to add n number of term, we needed n minus 1 adders. Okay, so you just remember the transversal or direct form. The other name of direct form structure of FIR system is called as transversal. Okay, so the transversal or direct form structure requires n multipliers, n minus 1 adders, as well as n minus 1 delay element. Delay element means Z inverse block. Okay, so already you know the elements used to realize the FIR system or IR system is that one is multiplier, another one is adder, and the delay block. Delay block is said to be Z inverse block. The next thing, which of the following is a method for implementing FIR system? Direct form, cascade form, lattice structure, all of the mentioned. All of the mentioned. So we can realize the FIR system in direct form, cascade form, lattice structure. So all of the above is the answer. Then the next one, what are the realization methods of FIR filter? So other than this direct form, cascade form, lattice form, what are the other forms? Means the first basic structure is the direct form or transversal structure. The second one is cascade form. The third one is linear phase realization. So this linear phase realization is very important in this FIR filter. So what is the advantage of this linear phase realization? Means, so already you know the FIR filter is a linear phase. All FIR filters are linear phase. Some FIR filters are linear phase FIR filter. So the linear phase FIR filter can be realized using this linear phase realization. So in that, the number of multipliers used reduced by half the amount. Okay, so that is the advantage of this direct form realization. Then the next form is polyphase realization, lattice realization. So these are all the different realization methods of FIR filter. Okay, then the next one. How many memory locations are used to store the output point of a sequence of length n in a direct form realization? So how many memory locations are used in order to store the output if the length is n in direct form realization? So the memory location needed is n minus 1 memory location. Okay, number of multiplier n, number of adder n minus 1. Similarly, number of delay element n minus 1, number of memory location is also n minus 1. Okay, then the next question, the direct form realization is often called transversal or tapped delay line filter. Yes, it's a true. The other name of direct form realization of the FIR filter is that transversal structure or tapped delay line filter. Okay, tapped delay line filter. Then the next one, what is the condition of N if the structure according to the form is as below? Okay, so here this rectangle box, it is a Z inverse block. Okay, delay element. So this is a Z inverse. Okay, similarly, this is also Z inverse. This one, this is the delay element block. Okay, this one, these are all the delay element blocks. And this thing, it's an adder. Okay, this is the adder. This circle, it indicates the adder element. So this structure indicates what is the condition of N. N means order. So this is the input X and this is the output we will get Y. Okay, so these are all the adders. Okay, again, it's adders. So this is this structure. You see, this structure, it is nothing but a linear phase realization of FIR filter. So in this, in linear phase realization, that is a linear, you know, the condition for the linear phase filter is the H of N equal to H of N minus 1 minus N. So the two coefficients is having the same value. So that's why number of multiplier used in this realization is automatically reduced by half the amount. Okay, that is the thing. So here you see, so how, what is the value of N? Okay, N means order of the filter. So here first X is given to this one and again given to here, this three. Okay, this three element. Similarly, in bottom also three element is there and in center one more delay element is there. Okay, so in center, this delay element is not there, means the value of N is even. Okay, in center, one separate delay element is there, means the condition for N is the N should be odd. Okay, the N should be odd. And the combined, that is the two coefficient, the common coefficients are taken and that coefficients are added and multiplied by one single multiplier. So that structure is called as a transversal, that is a linear phase realization structure. Okay. Then the next one, in tapped delay line filter, the tapped line is also known as dash. Pick on node, pick off node, pick up node, pick down node. In tapped delay line filter, the tapped line, it is known as pick off node. Okay, pick off node. Then the next question, in linear phase realization, equal valued coefficients are taken common for reducing the number of dash. Okay, so you see, this is a linear phase realization. So in this linear phase realization, the same coefficients are commonly taken in order to reduce what? That is, in order to reduce either adder, subtractor, multiplier, divider, in order to reduce multiplier. So two time multiplying with the same coefficient, we are taking the coefficient as a common, we multiplied only one time. Okay, so in linear phase realization, the equal valued coefficients are taken common for reducing the number of multipliers. Okay, this is the greatest advantage of the linear phase realization. Then the next question, check whether the H of Z is equal to 1 plus 2 Z inverse plus 2 Z power minus 2 plus Z power minus 3 is linear phase filter or not. Okay, so in order to verify transfer function H of Z, okay, this filter is a linear phase filter or not. So we have to, that is, what is the condition for linear phase filter means, if the H of Z and the H of Z inverse value, if both the values are same, means we can say that the given filter is a linear phase filter. Okay, so here the H of Z is given. So you see the H of Z, you just write. Then here the H of Z is having Z power minus 1 coefficients. Okay, so that's why you just convert this negative coefficient into positive coefficient. That is, you know, the Z inverse, this Z inverse can be written as 1 by Z. Okay, similarly, the Z power minus 2 can be written as 1 divided by Z squared. So that's why it can be written as 1 plus 2 by Z plus 2 by Z squared plus 1 divided by Z power 3. So if you are taking LCM, after taking LCM, you see Z power 3 plus 2z squared plus 2z plus 1 divided by z power 3. So you consider this is the equation number 1. Okay, then in this h of z equation, you just replace z by z inverse. Okay, if you are replacing this z by z inverse, we will get a h of z inverse. So the h of z inverse is equal to 1 plus the z can be replaced by z inverse. So the z inverse can be replaced by z. So 2z plus 2z squared plus z power 3. And you just check this equation number 1 and 2 is equal or not. Okay, this 2 is not equal. The h of z is this one. H of z inverse is this one. This two thing is not equal. Okay, except this h of z is having this term divided by z power 3. This term is having only the numerator. So the h of z inverse is not equal. So that's why the filter is not a linear phase filter. So the answer is this is no. The linear phase filter, it's not a linear phase filter. Okay, this is the one of the problem. Then the next one, in cascaded form realization, the polynomials are factored into. Okay, so you know another form of realization is cascaded form realization. So in cascaded form, we have to split the transfer function, the h of z, into product of the lower order transfer function h1, h2, etc. Okay, so in cascaded form realization, the polynomials are factored into a product of first order and second order polynomial, product of second and third order, sum of first order, second order, sum of second order and third order. So product of first order and second order polynomial. Okay, this is the correct one. Then in parallel form realization, the transfer function can be, okay. So in parallel form realization, the transfer function H, we have to express as an addition of H1 and H2. Okay, this is the difference between parallel and cascade form. In cascade form, the H, the total transfer function can be split as multiplication of H1 into H2. In parallel form realization, the H of Z can be split as an addition of H1 and H2. So in parallel form realization, the transfer function can be expressed as a product, no. Expressed as an addition of single order function, yes. Okay, it's a correct answer. It can be expressed as an addition of single order transfer function H1 plus H2, etc. Then the next thing, in parallel form realization is done in high speed filtering, low speed filtering, both A and B, none of the above. The parallel form realization is done in high speed filtering applications. Okay. The next thing, what is the expression for impulse response of FIR filter using the Fourier series method for the corresponding frequency response? So the frequency response capital H of e power j omega means, what is the corresponding impulse response of the FIR filter in Fourier series method? Okay, so you know the formula in Fourier series method of realizing the FIR filter. The given data is frequency response. From that frequency response, we have to find the desired impulse response. Okay, so the formula is that HD of n equal to 1 by 2 pi integration over minus pi to pi HD of e power j omega, e power j omega n d omega. Okay, this is the correct formula. Then the next question, what are the disadvantages of Fourier series method? So already you know, in order to design the FIR filter, there are four methods are there. One is Fourier series method and different windowing methods and frequency sampling method. So the first Fourier series method. So in Fourier series method, from the frequency response, using this formula, first we have to find the impulse response. Okay, then this impulse response is of infinite duration. We have to truncate this impulse response to finite duration in order to design FIR filter. Okay, so in designing FIR filter using Fourier series method, the infinite duration impulse response is truncated suddenly at n equal to plus or minus n minus 1 by 2. That is, the infinite number of impulse response is only truncated to the center n values. Okay, the remaining impulse response we truncated. So because of this truncation of this Fourier series method, it will lead to a fixed percentage of overshoots and undershoots before and after an approximated discontinuity in the frequency response. So because of this truncation, we will get the frequency response. In the frequency response of that particular filter, we will get the sudden overshoots and undershoots. Okay, that is, we will get some oscillation, unwanted oscillation in the that pass band and stop band. So that thing, that is the disadvantage of the Fourier series method. So in order to avoid this disadvantage of Fourier series method, so instead of designing FIR filter using this Fourier series method, we are moving to the next technique, windowing technique. So instead of direct truncation, in windowing technique, we are multiplying this HD of N with windowing technique in order to obtain the finite duration sequence. And then we are designing. Okay, so that's a windowing technique. Then the next one, what is Gibbs phenomenon? So in this, that is a, this Gibbs phenomenon, Gibbs oscillation is occurred in the Fourier series method of designing FIR filter. Okay, so already we discussed, you know, that is in designing FIR filter using Fourier series method, the infinite duration impulse response is truncated suddenly at n equal to plus or minus n minus 1 by 2. So due to the abrupt truncation of this series will lead to oscillation in both pass band and stop band. Okay, so we will not get a constant pass band and stop band. We will get a ripples, okay, oscillation. So this oscillation is called as Gibbs oscillation or Gibbs phenomenon. Okay, so this is the so in order to avoid this Gibbs oscillation, instead of using Fourier series method, we are using the method, it is called as a windowing technique or Fourier frequency sampling method of designing FIR filter. Okay, so these are all the some of the questions about the realization of FIR filter. So in that, so there may be a chance to ask the diagram, okay, the transversal diagram for that is the direct form realization of the given FIR filter H of Z. Okay, so that's also one of the 2-mark question. May come, you just see. Then thanks for watching my channel and please subscribe my channel for more videos. So in my channel, in the DTSP or discrete time signal processing playlist, all MCQ videos are available. So you can learn, or I will give the remaining videos link in the description box, you can see. Okay, so we'll meet in the next video. Thank you.